And welcome to the next installment of our technical overview videos in our partner innovation video series. My name is Steve Busby, and I'm a part of the Azure IoT engineering team. I'm a principal program manager helping drive our digital twins ecosystem through strategic partnerships. One such strategic partnership is our partnership with Unity. Today, we're talking with Leon Mura and Jim Bowen from Unity about their immersive digital twins visualization solutions. We're very excited to have Jim and Leon here and to drill down into the solution. Let's get going with some introductions.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jim Bowen, and I'm one of the global heads of program management for Unity's Accelerate Solutions team. And I had the pleasure of working with Leon and Microsoft on a collaboration to develop a learning path to educate developers on how to use Unity and Microsoft Azure platforms. The use case we selected was the creation of a digital twin of a wind farm, building an interactive and immersive mixed reality experience for the Microsoft HoloLens.
Hi, I'm Leon Mura, a software development lead at Unity's Accelerate Solutions. Working in close collaboration with Microsoft, I was in charge of leveraging the different technologies to develop a solution that integrated data and functionality into a cohesive learning exercise. I led the technical team that built a starter project for people needing to implement their own solutions on Azure Digital Twins.
Great, thanks for joining, guys. So Jim, can you talk a little bit about the technical value to our customers for the partnership between Unity and Microsoft? In particular, why the focus on digital twins in the collaboration?
Yeah, for sure, Steve. Most of the listeners are already familiar with Azure IoT and possibly Azure Digital Twins. And some might be aware that Unity has digital twin offerings as well. Both companies' offerings are strongest when combined to form a technical ecosystem that promotes rapid development and tight integration. By combining the visualization and connectivity capabilities of Unity with the power of Azure Platform, you're able to create these rich, immersive experiences to help make data-driven decision-making, all in real time. The joint project we completed demonstrated the ability to support entire life cycles of digital twins, from design through to operate and even into taking action. So maybe before Leon dives into some of the technical details around our project, I'd like to outline some of the high-level solution architecture concepts to provide some context. And so as I mentioned, both Microsoft and Unity have digital twin offerings, and the technologies not only integrate well together, but the combination is stronger than the sum of the parts. Some of the specific value offerings of each of the platform can be seen here on this slide. I don't intend to run through all of those, but the key takeaway here is that Unity delivers real-time 3D visualization of assets and provides a vehicle for that immersive integration, kind of like a system of systems. While Azure IoT and ADT form a bidirectional surface to stream real-time data from connected devices and to raise events. So Leon will speak more to some of the specific services and architecture that really help bring the digital twin to life.
Thanks, Jim. So Leon, as one of the lead architects on the MS Learn module that demonstrates how to join our two powerful platforms, you've got some great firsthand knowledge how it all works. Can you give us a view into the high level technical architecture pattern for this integration?
Sure, Steve. So at the highest level, we can think of three elements. We have the devices, the backend, and consumers of the data. And we'll break this down a bit. So devices are the IoT capable devices, typically gathering sensor data and sending it to our backend. The backend consists of a set of Azure services, the main ones being the Azure IoT Hub and the Azure Digital Twins. So the IoT Hub manages the devices and receives data from them. It then forwards it on to the Digital Twin service, and that's where the logical structure of our Digital Twins is defined, so kind of where Digital Twins live. Then the consumers of the data can be an array of different things. So depending on whether you're doing, you're wanting to consume the data in real time, or doing more of a post-processing approach, you would have one type or another of consumers, and you can combine as many of them as you need. So in our example, we rely on SignalR for real-time communication from the service to our Unity app. But if instead you're interested in long-term data storage or analysis, you could, for example, add time series insights as another output, and from there, connect to blob storage or Power BI for further analysis.
Thanks, Leon. That makes sense. It would be great to see the Unity solution in action. Can you give us some details on the integration and maybe show us a demo?
Sure, Steve. In our case, the integration with ADT is done through SignalR. In our backend, we've set up an Azure SignalR service, and in our Unity app, we implemented a SignalR client. This establishes a persistent connection between the service and the app and allows data to be streamed continuously from the service to the client as soon as it's available. This is a good time to introduce the demo. Our use case revolves around our reliability engineer managing a wind farm who needs to view the data in real time. They need to be notified of potential problems, and they can resolve issues remotely by sending commands to the digital twin. So this is our project in Unity. This is our scene. And I want to start out by saying that in Unity, anything that is present in our scene is a game object, which you see here in the hierarchy panel. A special type of game object we use to accelerate development are prefabs, or more precisely, prefab instances. So prefabs are a template from which game objects can be instantiated. Changes to the definition of the prefab affect all the existing instances based on it. Now, broadly speaking, the elements we need in our scene are a terrain, digital twin objects, so wind turbines in our case, a user interface, and game objects containing the logic for user input and for interacting with the Azure digital twin services. So let's look at these objects in our Unity scene hierarchy. The first one is Bing Maps Operate. This is used to render a 3D map with data streaming in from Bing Maps. This gives some physical context to our app.
Yeah, Leon, that's awesome. Using Maps SDK with Unity is pretty simple, and it's quick to add that map data. And you can do things like change coordinates, zoom, pan, et cetera. And we know that ability to add contextual information to a digital twin experience is so important to infuse elements of reality into your digital twin scenarios. You've showcased the 3D maps here in this demo, and I know that you and the rest of the solutions team add other contextual information for clients, such as GIS data, LiDAR, photogrammetric scans, and CFD and atmospheric effects as well.
That's right, Dan. That's great insight. So let's go to the next object that we're looking at here today. So it's Operate Scene UI, and it contains almost all of the elements that make up our graphical interface of our app. So things like the panel that shows the turbine data streaming in from ADT, alerts and buttons. And also this UI is provided as a starting point and to kind of get our example across, but it can also be modified to meet the needs of different projects.
Leon, I know you and the dev team work closely with the Unity design team to create some simple and intuitive UX to translate all that streaming telemetry events into some meaningful context for the engineers to look at and analyze. And most of those, the real world assets that we end up modeling are quite complex and connected to many different sensors and data points. So for example, like a wind turbine, contain upwards of 1,000 different sensors, actuators, gauges, and power conditioning controls. All that data needs to be handled and managed effectively and efficiently.
That's right, Jim. And speaking of data, the next things I want to talk about here are exactly about that. So the next object is ADT connection. So this connects to our Azure Digital Twin service through the SignalR endpoint. So we have to set the URL here, and it starts receiving the stream of data. When it receives it, it stores it in some scriptable objects and raises events so that the rest of the app can get access to that data as soon as it's received.
Yeah, Leon, this component is pretty exciting. And something else to mention here is that we're working with a number of customers in the industrial and environmental spaces to extend the capabilities of the digital twin to support and connect to even more complex modeling, analytics, machine learning, computer vision, and enterprise data stores. And you pointed some of that out on the architectural, technical architectural diagram. And that connectivity can come from, you know, either through ADT or facilitated by Unity.
That's right. So there's one last thing that I want to show here. So the ADT turbine alert controller. So this handles the case of when we receive an alert from the service and we need to take an action to resolve it. So when a message comes in, that is, what, let's say, type alert, we get notified in the UI. And we also enable a button for a user to send a reset command, in our case, to the digital twin. It can be anything else, like creating a service ticket, or there's a bunch of options.
Yeah, this extends the capabilities, of the operator, that digital twin, to control and take action based on that real-time streaming data, and most importantly, based on the data patterns and the correlations that they're seeing in Unity and in that mixed reality or 3D experience. And our example was around wind turbines, but it's pretty easy to visualize the power of being able to control your assets from within the Unity and Azure environment, whether it's like a manufacturing facility, an airport, hospital, or traffic-related environments.
That's right, and that's a very important point to get across, that the use case of the wind turbines is just an example, and in the end, it can be anything. So at a high level, these are the elements that come together to form our digital twin experience. The other important thing that I want to show here is the way our application stores and uses the data coming in from ADT. So in the Unity toolbox, we have a special kind of object known as a scriptable object. These can act as containers for data and can also share the data with the rest of the app. So I want to show here this folder where we have our scriptable objects for our turbines and our turbine site, so the wind farm. So in this case, the wind farm has a list of the turbines, and then for each turbine, we have the data for it. So in this first section, we store the data that comes in streaming. So these are just some initial values, but they really get replaced with whatever is coming in real time from ADT. There's also some metadata, like a name for the turbine, a location, height, that type of data. So when we receive this data, we raise an event and pass that object along to the rest of the app. So then you can have different, you could call them consumers, actually, or listeners within the app that receive that data and treat it. So for example, you could have the UI panels. You could have a logger that takes in the data and writes to a file, and just have the data available to all of your app. So after this not so quick overview, I think we can go ahead and run the application. So in this case, for our example, we, instead of using a real turbine, we use this device simulator app, or instead of a wind farm. So this is simulating to be the wind farm. So this is connecting to the IoT hub using a connection string, registering devices with it, and sending the data to the IoT hub. So this is what the real IoT-enabled wind turbines would do. We're just simulating it through a console app. So here we can see it connected. This is establishing the connection, registering the devices with IoT Hub, and now we'll start sending data. So I'll press a key to get that process started. Here we see a log of the data being sent. I don't expect you to read that fast. But then this is now being sent to the IoT Hub, from them to ADT, Azure Digital Twins. In the end, it goes through SignalR to our Unity app. So if we go now to our Unity app and start running it, we will see that data coming in. Mostly because of keeping the example simple, keeping throughput low, we're sending data every 5 seconds or so. This could be more than once a second. It could be whatever rate you would need in your application. So it takes a few seconds, but now you can see how data is updating there. You can look at the data kind of in more detail for each specific turbine. And then the other thing, of course, is the turbine themselves and the map. So here, this is our site, And that side overview panel there is showing data about these turbines and also some that are outside of our view, which are represented by those blue arrows. So so here's, again, the data coming in. You can select the turbine and see the details for it. And the, to kind of bring it back to our use case or to the next part of it, we're going to go to the device simulator and send an alert. So for now, we've only been reviewing the data that's coming in. It all looks good so far. Now we're going to send an alert. So we've sent the alert now. It went to ADT. And it's finally, it's now reached our app here. And you can see that the, you know, the sensor data is now different because it's reflecting the alert. So if we inspect now, we see that that alert icon there, some updated telemetry, and we see an event description of what the alert is. And this allows us to take action. So this could be, you know, creating that service ticket, sending a reset command, or whatever else is relevant to your application. Here we send a reset command and we get a confirmation. This is originally designed for HoloLens and I'm running it in the Unity editor, so it looks a little different. But this completes kind of the cycle of the whole data flow, how it starts with the devices or the device simulators in our case, goes through the whole Azure Digital Twins pipeline and finally reaches our app in Unity. And we end up sending a command back to Azure Digital Twins. So that's it for the demo.
Thanks, Leon and Jim. That was great. So if a customer is thinking about approaching a digital twins visualization project, do they have to already have a detailed 3D model of their environment, or can you help customers who may not have pre-existing models of their assets get started?
Yeah, great question, Steve. And that's actually a very common inquiry from many of our customers. We recommend matching the fidelity of your 3D model to your business requirements. So some of our customers start with a simple bounding box derived from existing data, such as 2D CAD or GIS, to establish that 3D geometry of which you can connect up your metadata. Others use point clouds derived from LiDAR or photogrammetry to extract assets, while the most comprehensive solutions see clients importing like 3D assets from various stores, or leverage true 3D CAD or BIM models that they may possess. It comes down kind of to desired accuracy and use case versus time and costs.
That's great info, Jim. Glad to know that we can help those customers as well. Thanks to you both for joining me and sharing more about this exciting solution and partnership.
I really enjoyed the discussion, Steve, and look forward to helping enable more digital twin creators.
Thanks, Dave, for the chance to spread the word.
Thank you all for watching. Check out the link to the Learn module if you want to try this integration yourself. And stay tuned for our next video highlighting the awesome work our partners are doing for our customers.